I'm Gayle Laakmann McDowell, author of Cracking Coding Interview. In this video, we're going to cover merge sort.
Merge sort is a pretty efficient sorting algorithm, and the best way to conceptualize merge sort is recursively. So suppose we had this large array, and we wanted to sort it. Well, what if we could magically sort the left half and sort the right half? And so then we, get back two sorted halves. Well, then if we wanted to make the whole array sorted, all we have to do is merge those in sorted order. And that's what merge sort is. And what we do to sort the left half and the right half is just apply merge sort again. So we apply merge sort to the left half, apply merge sort to the right half, and merge those back in order. Now, in order to have sorted the left half, we again apply left, try merge sort to the left portion of that, apply merge sort to the right portion of that, and do the same thing on the other side. So we do this over and over again, and eventually our array becomes sorted. The nice thing about merge sort is that it's pretty fast. It will always give us an n log n runtime. There's no case where our array looks really funky or something like that and it degenerates. It's doing the exact same thing every time. So that's really nice. The downside though is that merging two arrays together generally requires extra space. It's pretty hard to do it without that extra memory. So we need to copy all the elements into a new array, merge them, and then copy them back. And that's a little bit of a downside. But with that said, let's turn now to the implementation of it.
Implementing merge sort isn't too hard if we just think very carefully about what exactly we're doing. So when we do merge sort, what we want to do is sort the left half, sort the right half, and then merge those two halves. So we're going to do this recursively. So I have just an overall method here that calls merge sort. But we're going to want a recursive method. So I'll use this as a helper method. And then we're going to want to pass in left and right parameters. So it's going to sort the left half, which starts at 0, through the right half, which goes to array.length minus 1. And then this will be our recursive method. So we'll pass in the array, the left start, I'll call it, and the right end. And then what I'm going to do is say, okay, if these things are kind of out of bounds, so if left start is greater than or equal to right end, then we're done here, just return. Otherwise, I want to do merge sort on the left half, and I'm going to need to get my middle point. So middle is going to be left start plus right end over 2, so right in between those two. So I'm going to sort from the left starting position to the middle, so the left half. Then I'm going to sort the middle plus 1, so the right starting position, to the right end. And then I'm going to want to merge my halves. So call array, merge from the left starting position to the right end. So that's the very, very basics of what our code might look like. Now we just need to implement the merge halves method. So I'm going to write out this method, merge halves, and it's going to take in my integer array, and then it's going to take in my left starting position and my right end position. And then it's going to divide the array in half and merge each half. Now, as we said in the introduction, one thing we're going to want to do when merging is it's very difficult to merge in place. So we actually need a temporary array to copy elements into as we're merging. And rather than creating a new temporary array every single time, what we call merge halves, we're just going to create one temporary array that we use the entire time. And actually, so I'm going to create it way up here. So I'm going to create a new temporary array that is, since the same size as the original array. And I'm going to use this entire time. Makes it a little bit more efficient. So I'm going to update all these things to pass in my temporary array. And one last update here. Okay, so now we have the basics of the code laid out. So now I need to get my left end position, which is just going to be right end plus left start divided by 2, essentially the same thing you see for middle. And right start is just the next value, left end plus 1. Okay. And then, let's see, what else do I need? Okay, and then the whole size of my array is going to be right end minus left start plus one. So that's the whole, that's the total number of elements we're copying over. And then as I do the sorted merge, I'm gonna need a left index, and it's gonna start off with left start, a right index that's gonna start off at right start. And then I'm gonna need an index into this temporary array where I'm copying elements. And that's gonna actually also start off at left start. Now I'm going to walk through the two halves, copying over the smaller element. So while left is less than or equal to left start, left end, and right is less than or equal to right end. So while they're both still in bounds, copy of the smaller element. So if array dot or array of left is less than or equal to array of right, then copy array of left in, and then move both pointers. So index plus plus and left plus plus. Otherwise, copy over the right element. So temp of index equals array of right, and then I just have to move right. And since I'm always moving index, I'm actually just gonna move this over into common code down here. Okay, so this is walking through each half of the array and copying over the smaller element. Once one of these pointers goes out of bounds, what I need to do is just copy over the smaller elements, copy over the remainder of the elements. So there's different ways of doing this. One thing we could do is just write a for loop that walks the remainder of the elements on either the left or the right side. Or in Java, I could actually call this array copy element, array copy method. And what this does is it, given two arrays, copies the elements from one array into the other array, and you can give it specific boundaries. In this case, our source is array, so we're gonna copy from array, starting from the left pointer, and we wanna copy into temp, starting from its index, and we wanna copy in how many elements? We wanna copy in left end minus left plus one. So that'll copy the remaining elements from the left side. Then we do basically the same thing on the right side. So we copy from array's right pointer and temp.index, and then this is gonna be right end minus right plus one. And then we copy everything from temp back into array. So now our source is temp. We wanna copy from the left starting position into array starting from its left starting position. And we want to copy in size, number of elements. Now note that because of the for loop conditions or the while loop conditions on line 31 up here, only the left or the right side will have remaining elements. One of them will be out their boundary and the other one will not. So when we look at these two lines, line 42 and 43, only one or the other will have an effect, but that's okay. We can just say, essentially, copy the remaining left elements over and copy the remaining right elements over, even though only one of the arrays actually, or only one of the sides actually has remaining elements. That'll be perfectly fine to do. And then, again, then we wrap up with just copying everything back. So that's how we do merge sort. We just divide, you know, it follows very naturally from the algorithm that was explained. Divide the array in half, sort the left half, sort the right half, and then merge. And merging is pretty simple. It's a little bit of pointer stuff. We have to be kind of careful here that we don't make mistakes, but it's really just walking through the elements, copying over the smaller element, then copy the remaining elements in from left and right half into this temporary array, and then copying everything back into the original array. It's fairly straightforward. So now we can run this and see that yes, in fact, it does give us back a sorted array. So now that you've seen the basics of how merge sort works, remember that in the real world, you probably won't actually implement a sorting algorithm from scratch, but it's still useful to see the actual implementation of it. So now that you've seen this, why don't you try out a new problem that applies sorting to that algorithm? Good luck.